Hi and Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today I will present my review paper with the title Review on Staphylococcus Infection in Fishes. My name is Basira binti Muhammad Zafri, S52215, and my supervisor is Prof. Nadia binti Musa. For the introduction background of study, Staphylococcus infection in fishes has been recorded in both wild and cultured fishes worldwide. It is one of the most serious diseases since it can cause fish mortalities which lead to economic losses. There are more than 50 species of this, and Staphylococcus inae, agalactae, dysagalactae, and parobaris are the most commonly have been reported to infect fish. Besides, the first outbreak of Staphylococcus in fish was recorded in rainbow trout culture in Japan. Meanwhile, Staphylococcus outbreak in Malaysia was first documented in 1997, which Staphylococcus agalactae were observed in red hybrid tilapia in the Pahang River. The significance of study is the information and knowledge provided can be used for further apply to the all farmers and fisheries producer to overcome Staphylococcus infection. And this study also helped to improve the health of the aquatic organism against Staphylococcus infection and increase the resistance to the disease. The problem statement are there are lack of study and information in treated Staphylococcus infection, and Staphylococcus infection in fish are destructive disease since it can cause huge fish mortalities. The objective of this study is to support information gathering on Staphylococcus infection in fishes and to discuss the treatments and prevention method to prevent the disease. There are three methods used for the methodology, which is search strategy, study selection, and data organizing and reporting. First, I search articles from database, namely Google Scholar, Science Direct, ResearchGate, Willy Online, and Springlink. I use keywords such as Staphylococcus, Staphylococcus, clinical signs, diagnostic methods, treatment, and prevention. In the study selection, I choose journal articles based on the title, abstract, and conclusion. I use journal article from the database and select the article published in English only. For the data organizing and reporting, all the information from each study were sized and organized according to data about the Staphylococcus species, experimental method outcome, author's name, and year of publication. For the result and discussion, this is the table and maps of the Staphylococcus agalactae cases that have been reported in Peninsula Malaysia. Staphylococcus agalactae are believed to be the most commonly species that have been reported in Peninsula Malaysia. For the clinical sign and symptom, the most common that can be observed are the displacement of the spine, loss of appetite, pop eye, eye hemorrhage, and erratic swimming. Other clinical signs are including the hemorrhage around the anus or the base of anus, congested visceral organ, particularly liver, spleen, and kidney, while the brain appears soft and occasionally edematous. In addition, subclinical infection lead to reduced in growth due to the decreasing of fish appetite, which consequently extend the growth out duration. For the diagnostic method, there are few diagnostic methods used to detect Staphylococcus infection in fishes, such as by the observation on clinical sign and symptom, bacterial isolation, molecular methods, and biochemical methods. Molecular diagnostic methods are more accurate and detailed for bacterial identification at the species level. Besides, the internal organs such as brain, heart, kidney, spleen, and liver typically provide the best result by using the bacteriology technique. Because of there are no obvious symptoms and signs in some cases, bacterial isolation and identification was found to be the effective diagnostic method. Furthermore, antibiotics also have been used as the treatment for the Staphylococcus infection. Among the antibiotics are oxytetracycline, amoxicillin, fluorphenicol, erythromycin, and others. In most cases, the consumption of oral antibiotic treatments are ineffective as it have a reduced appetite of the infected fish and could only partially control rates of mortality during the application period. When the antibiotic is over, mortality usually increases again. Among the effective prevention and control strategies, vaccination is one of the key practices. Immunization strategy by the intraperitoneal vaccination is the most often used, although oral, immersion and spray have been attempted with variable results. Kill vaccines are usually administered by the intraperitoneal or intramuscular injection of individual fish. And lastly, management. The preventive measure also depends on the combination element of farm site selection and the development of great aquaculture farm management. Biosecurity measures for all hatchery and farm is recommended, which is practices and producer use to prevent the introduction and spread of infection. This table shows the data list of etiological agent, host, chemical and antibiotic treatment used to treat fish infected with enterococcus infections worldwide. And this table shows the data list of etiological agents, host and vaccine treatment used to control and treat fish infected with enterococcus infection worldwide. For the conclusion, the existence of enterococcus infection has been identified in freshwater and marine fish and causing millions of economic losses worldwide. Besides, the most commonly diagnostic method used to detect this enterococcus infection in fish are through the molecular methods. Lastly, although antibiotic was not really suggested, combination of good aquaculture farm practices and proper vaccination program could be the best plan to prevent and control enterococcus infection. This is the reference. That's all for me. Thank you.